And yes, yes.
Thank you, Aparna. I was waiting to respond to Mary, and I think that's a very important question she has raised. For the last year and a half or two, we've been sort of collaborating with the Department of Science and Technology in coming up with a nationwide teacher education possibility. Of course, when one goes nationwide, it's really huge, almost intractable, and we were looking at it in that sense. There are 600 to 700 districts. So we were looking at how can we look at something that happens at a district level and then scale it up to the entire country. And some of the idea, of course, it's a huge plan and it will take a long time to discuss it. But suffice it to say that what it involved was looking at schools at the district level. So there was a district level coordinating agency. It could be the DIET, it could be any one of the educational institutions that already exist. So the business was not to create any more parallel paths, but to use and empower and strengthen existing educational bodies with support from other institutional institutions that exist there. One example is that we in our country have teachers do their bachelor's or 12th standard or whatever, depending on whether it's DED or BED, and then go on to educational degree, professional degree. And the professional degree is then divorced from subject. So this divorce of a professional degree from the subject really puts the teacher at a disadvantage. After that, she knows she's learning or he is learning pedagogy different from subject. Whereas actually teaching in the classroom is about pedagogy and subject going together. Most countries in the world have this teacher education in a university located within it. In our country, we have an NCTE as apart from UGC, which the entire thing is really a messy thing if you ask me. Okay, without having to change all of that, which we can't do, we were looking at district level cooperative bodies, support systems, where universities and university teachers join hand with school teachers. So essentially break the vertical barriers so that we have even college students. If you have an engineering college, you have supposedly some of the more brighter students going into engineering or doctor degree or even for that matter science education, so science degrees. So get them to partner with elementary school teachers, and we have programs where these partnerships are rewarded. There are NSS programs in university which can use students partnering with schools, for example. So use existing facilities and existing spaces for such partnerships to happen. And for teachers to do inquiries in the classroom, teachers as learners, like we said, where they innovate. And these innovations don't reward individual teachers. So 100 rewards for 100 teachers actually alienates that one teacher from the remaining teachers. Isko kya shing lagenge? You know, do they have horns that they have? They're different, they get rewarded, so he's a different kind of teacher, I can't be. So that's the way it sort of alienates. Create collectives, create teacher collectives. Teacher collectives together with principal collectives, principals as part of that collective, headmasters as part of that collective, college teachers and college students as part of that collective. So districts grow with these kind of partnerships. The other partnership that we're looking at is scientific institutions. We're looking at scientists adopt a school. One scientist adopts several schools, in fact, not necessarily one, because all you might, depending on the time available, we require the scientist to make at least one monthly meeting with that school. So depending on that, I mean, teachers can ask questions to the scientists. They feel they're theirs, they own them, so to speak, and scientists feel that they're giving something back to the society. Okay, so we're looking at these partnerships to support teachers in their lonely endeavors to try out something new in the classroom. Like we said, learning by doing is a very difficult thing to do. The moment you set children to do things and they come up with questions, teachers have no answers for them. Okay, very often. Who will answer them? Who will answer the teacher? Who will support the teacher? And we're looking at such supporting partnerships. In fact, that is a very detailed project that we had laid out for the DST. Actually, it was a little mid-plan kind of thing, and they haven't taken it up for one reason or the other. But we are willing to share that, which has district components, state-level components, where it actually has state-level departments of councils of science and technology actually working in partnership with the SERTs and all the other educational bodies that they have. So you have this 5,000, as he said, the educational supervisors being supported by 50,000 other people who are in partnership with that, with those people. And I think there is a very urgent need to look at forming such communities who will then ensure that the education is on the right track, rather than merely schools or just that one trying to do that, and strengthening the existing bodies to do what they're doing much better than they are. So I'll suffice it to say that such things are important and doable, and that they need deliberation at various levels and partnerships at all levels. Thank you very much.
Oh, wait, I'll just make a quick, if it's a one or two sentence, because...
just to add that this doesn't leave out NGOs.